In the year 2017, the Ministry of Sanitation was created, and His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Ghana, made it a very passionate appeal that he wants Ghana to be a cleanest country, Accra should be a cleanest city. And so Zoom Lion took up this kind of challenge that, look, we must really heed to the President's call by putting all our strategies and measures to see how best we could help. So what we did was try to see, look at the whole overview of our fleet, and we saw that we have to increase the fleet. So we, in the year 2018, we brought in about 500 trucks, which was inaugurated at Independence Square. It was distributed to the districts. Then we saw that, look, we need dustbins in every house. So we, in collaboration with Ecobank, also have initiated the production of about 1 million dustbins. As we speak now, about 200,000 have been produced, and we are in constant touch with the metropolitan and municipal assemblies to see how best they can take over the bins, and then it's be distributed. You are not paying for it, it's free. And then you just pay for the services of that. And then also, we also have embarked on expanding where the facilities, where we treat the waste. Currently, we are treating one at Aji Kotoku, where it's able to treat about 600 tons. We are also constructing one at Jamestown, which is also able to have a capacity of about 400 tons. And then there are also plans advanced to also have one at Kasua and other areas. Then we also look at Kumasi, because we are talking about the whole country. So Kumasi, just about 2 weeks ago, we have commenced a fecal treatment plant. For the past 60 years in the history of this country, Kumasi have never experienced a fecal treatment plant. And when you, as you go now, you see that it's on the fecal matter is in ponds and it's spilling over into other rivers. Zoom Lion took up this challenge to have a befitting kind of, if Kumasi is the second largest city of this country, it must have a facility that is able to treat a fecal matter. And if you go now, you see a modern compost and recycling plant there. And then beside it, it has commenced an edifice of a fecal treatment plant, a modern with an ISO standard. And we are in partnership with the Hungarian company, a company called Pireco. The Hungarian government gave us a facility of about 13 million euro through Pereco, and they are doing that. We also have commenced having established one region, one compost and recycling plant. As we speak now, Takoradi is going to commence soon, Tamale, and then the other regions. All the 16 regions now are going to have a recycling. This shows that the infrastructure to treat the waste and to handle waste, Zoom Lion has taken the bold step and the lead in dealing with it. And what we are humbly appealing is that all the citizenry, we must all contribute. It is worth to note that the chairman of the Church of Pentecost, Apostle Eric Nyameche, in the vision of the church 5-year plan, they have what we call environmental care, which is part of their strategy in dealing with social issues. And so we were invited by the church to participate because of our logistical capacity. And as we speak now, we launched just about last year one of it at Kasua, and we have begun wherever the church calls on us, we move there, and we are inviting all other religious bodies and other churches to also invite us, will come, civil societies when you invite us will come, schools and universities when you come, anyone who is interested to make this call of making Accra and Ghana the cleanest, the city and the cleanest country, please call on us. We will come to your aid and we will support, because we cannot do it alone. We need all and sundry to really help us. His Eminence Sheikh Saributu, the Chief Imam, also have extended hands. We have a discussion, and he has called on all the imams also to use this platform and also to help and assist, which is also going very well. So the media also, we are appealing to you that as you did with this Galamsey call, by trying to call the attention of the populace, we are pleading that waste also, we need your intervention, as you did. We know that through the media, we'll be able to reach everyone that, look, this country can achieve the status of Kigali, Dubai, and any other country. And when you ask other countries how they did it, They said, the way you have started, Zoom Lion, that's how we did it. So I think that we are getting somewhere. You could see the achievement. Today, we have adored 10 brand new road sweepers. And the reason being that you have the highways and most ceremonial streets, and how the vehicles ply on that. It is not humanly possible that people can be sweeping all, especially in the medians. So what we have done is to introduce this modern equipment to be able to augment, especially on the highways when you are talking about the motorway, the N1s and other things. You need vehicles like this. Human beings cannot be sweeping. It may vehicles may just knock some of them down. And so to protect our workers, we have brought in this equipment to augment and to support. This shows the company's commitment, the desire that whenever there's attention or whenever there's a call to solve problems in this country in terms of waste, Zoom Lion is ready. And this has shown that we are in other parts of the country. We are in Angola, we are in Zambia. It shows the kind of track record we have. So I want to confidently say that Zoom Lion is one of the best companies to deal with waste management in this country in terms of academics, in terms of research, in terms of equipment, and a kind of even enlightenment. You could see that we are already there, and we are dealing with modern technology. This equipment is first of its kind here, and they are 2019 version. It has so many kind of systems to be able to operate, and every refuse on the street will be able to deal with it. So this is what this company stands for, and we are praying to the Almighty God for more ideas, more dreams, and more innovations to deal with waste in this country. This equipment, we liaise with our bankers and our manufacturers, and it's about $2 million invested into this equipment to work. And you could see that it's very modern, and it takes water, it takes oil, it takes so many things. And you could see, you all saw how it was being operated.